How's it going, guys? Blake here, and I'm back. It's been a while. I think it's been like 4 months since my last on-camera video. I've been back home in Los Angeles for the last 4 months. Pretty much, there wasn't a good layout for me to film videos, so I held off for the last few months, but I'm back here in Arizona now. Got a brand new room. Obviously, you guys can see my Dodgers wall right there. So, brand new room. School starts next week, but I am back. I'm going to be planning a bunch of new college football videos for this upcoming season, including today's. I have a bunch of fun little ideas planned, a bunch of little series plans. So hopefully, you know, you guys enjoy them. I definitely think that they're going to be great for you guys as college football viewers. I haven't really seen some of these videos, some of these ideas on YouTube so far. So hopefully this is something brand new. Hopefully you guys enjoy this content. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe for more college football videos in the future. It looks like the Harris Highlight Show will be coming back hopefully this week or maybe next week. I think this week we might be doing our first ever college football fantasy draft, just the four of us. We still have to figure out if we can get into the studio or not, if we're able to use cameras. So I'll keep you guys posted on that. But probably next week we'll have our first episode for season four. It'll be a complete college football preview, a complete college football breakdown. We'll be going over a whole bunch of stuff. So definitely stay tuned for that. So for today's video, I'm gonna be talking about the over-unders for the upcoming college football season. And of course, I'm gonna start with the Pac-12. So pretty much what I'm gonna be doing, I'm gonna be going and I'm gonna be seeing what the over-under for wins are according to Las Vegas. Now, the list that I got is from about middle of July, so I don't think these are gonna be too different, so these should be the current over-unders. So I'm pretty much gonna be giving a quick breakdown on each team and if I think they have more than the number of wins they're projected or less than the number of wins they're projected. But as I said, we're gonna start in the Pac-12, so let's get underway. And to no surprise, I'm gonna be starting with good old Arizona State. As you guys know, I go to Arizona State going into my final year here, graduating in December, so I'm excited about that. But let's start with the Sun Devils. Now, last season, the Sun Devils did go 7-6. Their current projected over-under is set at 7.5. Now, as of right now, I think Arizona State is going to hit the over. I think Arizona State's going to finish the season with 8 wins, and that's just looking at their 12-game schedule. As of right now, I have Arizona State losing on the road at Michigan State, on the road at Utah, at home against USC, and at home against Oregon. So right now, the Sun Devils, I have them going 8-4. I think Arizona State has the chance to potentially go 9-3. I think they also have the chance to go 6-6. I think they could potentially go 5-7. So a lot can happen with this schedule for Arizona State, but I like the way their schedule, you know, lays out. I like the fact they get Oregon at home. I like that they get USC at home. Really, their only tough road games are gonna be Michigan State and Utah. So those are gonna be two difficult ones. But overall, I think the Sun Devils, I'm gonna go with 8 wins as of right now. Up next, we got the Arizona Wildcats, who finished last season at 5-7. Their over-under is currently projected at 7, and I think I'm going to go with the under for this one. I have them winning only 5 games. Now, looking at their schedule, I think they're going to start the season 3-0. I think they're going to beat Hawaii, Northern Arizona, and I think they're going to beat Texas Tech, but the rest of their schedule, they have a tough break, including this one stretch where they have Washington, USC, at Stanford. You got a nice little game against Oregon State, but then at Oregon, home against Utah, and then on the road at Arizona State. I think it's going to be a tough season for Arizona. I'm going with 5 wins. I think they can go 6-6. I think their ceiling is 7-5. I can't see them winning more than 7 games, but I think 5-7 is a realistic season for the Wildcats. Moving over to my hometown of Southern California, we are going to start with the USC Trojans, who finished last season 5-7. Now, currently, USC's over-under is set at 6.5, and I think they are going to hit the over on that one. I think USC is going to win 7 games this upcoming season. Looking at their schedule right now, I think they're going to lose to Stanford, Utah, Washington, Notre Dame, and then Oregon. Now, USC's got a really tough 3-game stretch, arguably the toughest 3-game stretch of all Pac-12 teams this year. They got Utah at home, followed by on the road at Washington, on the road at Notre Dame. I think USC potentially can win one of those three, but I don't think it's likely. I think their best bet is probably at home against Utah, but even that's going to be a tough one. I think they lose those ones. They host Oregon late in the year. I think Oregon's going to be one of the best teams in the country this upcoming season. I do have them winning their final 3 games to put them at 7 wins. I think USC realistically can win 8 games this season. I think that's the max they can do. I wouldn't be shocked if they go 6-6, if they go 5-7, but I'm going to go with 7-5 as of right now. Switching to the other team in LA, we got the UCLA Bruins, who had a very disappointing last year, to say the least. They finished the season 3-9. Their current over-under is set at 5.5, And I'm going to go with the under on that one. I think UCLA wins 5 games. Now, I got them losing at home to Oklahoma, followed by a loss the next week at Washington State. Then I got them losing at Stanford, at home against Arizona State. And then I got them losing 3 in a row at the end of the season, at Utah, at USC, and at home against Cal. UCLA, they're definitely going to be improved this season. I definitely think UCLA can win up to probably 7 games, maybe around the 6 range. But ultimately, I got them winning 5 games. They got some really tough ones. I think the Washington State and Cal ones, you could probably flip, so you could probably give them those wins, giving them the 7, but it's a really tough schedule. But I think UCLA around 5 to 6 is probably fair, but I got them winning only 5 games this year. I just talked about them briefly, but we are going to talk about the Oregon Ducks. Last year, Oregon finished 9-4, and the current over-under is set at 9. Now, guys, I might need to make a video on my hot takes for the college football season. But I got Oregon going 12-0 this upcoming season. I'm hitting the over at 12 wins. Looking at their schedule, I mean, arguably their toughest game is probably going to be against Auburn week 1 at Jerry World. So that could be a coin toss right there. I ultimately think Oregon gets the job done. I wouldn't be shocked if they lose to Auburn. But looking at the rest of their schedule, I mean, they have one of the easiest schedules in the entire Pac-12. They got Nevada, then Montana, on the road at Stanford, Cal and Colorado at home. At Washington, that's probably going to be their second hardest game of the season, but I think they'll get the job done there. At home against Washington State, then on the road at USC, I think that could be another potentially tough game, but I think they'll get the job done. At home against Arizona, on the road at Arizona State, which is the second to last week of the season, I'll be there. I hope Arizona State can pull off the upset, but I don't think they'll be able to. And then at home against Oregon State, I think this is just a really easy schedule for Oregon. I think Justin Herbert's going to be really good. Oregon has a really good team. They were really good last year. I mean, they won 9 games. So I definitely think they're going to win more than last year. So I think at the absolute least, Oregon wins 10 games. I can't see them losing more than 2. And I think their ceiling is going undefeated. So I'm going to go with Oregon going 12-0 this year. Now, switching things over, I talk about the team who I think is going to have the best record in the Pac-12. This is who's going to have, without a doubt, the worst record in the Pac-12, and that's the Oregon State Beavers. Last season, they went only 2-10. Their current over-under is set at 2.5. And guys, I currently have the Oregon State Beavers winning 1 game this upcoming season. I mean, looking at the schedule, it's tough to really see who they can potentially beat. I got them beating Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, so that's their lone win of the season. Maybe they can squeak out a win on the road at Hawaii. I think that might be their best bet to win their second game of the season. But looking at this list, Oklahoma State at home, Stanford at home, on the road at UCLA, Utah, at Cal, at Arizona, Washington, Arizona State, Washington State, and Oregon. I just don't know where Oregon State can pick up a win other than Hawaii and Cal Poly. If we're talking about, if you had to choose one game that could potentially get it done, maybe on the road at Cal. That's just maybe, but their home games, I don't see them winning any games at home. And just at Washington State, at Oregon, at UCLA, at Arizona, I just don't see it. So Oregon State, I got them winning 1 game. I think at the absolute most, they pull out 3, and that's just if they beat Hawaii as well, and if they get 1 Pac-12 win. But Oregon State, it's going to be a rough year for the Beavers, but I got them going 1-11. Going now to the Utah Utes, they finished last season 9-4. Their current over-under is set at 9, and I think they hit the over with 10 wins. I think Utah is going to be the second best team this year in the Pac-12. Now, the 2 losses I have, the Utes going down, I got them losing to both Washington schools. Actually, I got them losing at home to Washington State and losing on the road to the Washington Huskies. Now, I think Utah, I think they have a chance to potentially go 11-1. I wouldn't be shocked there. I also think this is a team that can underwhelm. I wouldn't be surprised if they go 7-5, if they go 8-4, something like that. This is going to be a really good Utah team, a very under-the-radar Utah team. I know I've seen a lot of college football polls that have Utah kind of like in the top 10, finishing the season in the top 10. So I got them now finishing the season 10-2. Moving over now to Colorado, they finished last season going 5-7, a very disappointing season because if I remember correctly, they started the season 5-0, and then they lost 7 consecutive games to finish the season 5-7. Their over-under is currently set at 4.5, and I'm going to go with the under on that one. I actually only got them winning 3 games this upcoming season. I got them winning against Colorado State, against Air Force, and then Stanford at the end of the season. I mean, again, they have one of those tough schedules on the road at Arizona State, on the road at Oregon, on the road at Washington State. They travel to UCLA, and then their home games are going to be tough as well. You got Washington, Stanford, USC, Arizona. I think Colorado could potentially win 5 games max. I wouldn't be shocked if they beat Arizona. I wouldn't be shocked if they were to take down Stanford or UCLA, one of those games. But I think it's going to be a rough season in Colorado, so I got them currently only winning 3 games. Moving on to Stanford now, they finished last season 9-4. Their current over-under is set at 6.5, which seems very low for Stanford. I mean, it seems like every year they're consistently one of the better teams in the conference, but I'm currently going to go with the under this year. I got them winning only 5 games this year. Now, they got another tough schedule as well. They open up against Northwestern, which I have them as a win, but the next 3 are going to be very tough at USC, at UCF, and then at home against Oregon. I got them losing all those. Then an easy win against Oregon State, but then you got Washington. I got them winning a nice little string of UCLA and Arizona. At Colorado, I got them as a loss. At Washington State as a loss. Cal a win, and then they end the season at home against Notre Dame. So Stanford, as I mentioned, I got them winning 5 games. I could see them at most winning 7. I think 5, though, is kind of where they'll probably be around. I can't see them losing 8 games. I can't see them going 4-8 or something like that. So I think at the absolute worst, they go 5-7. My ultimate guess is right around 6-6, 5-7. But Stanford, I got them going 5-7 right now. Moving over to Cal now. They finished last year 7-6. A lot of people are high on Cal. I've seen Cal crack some top 25 polls to start the season. Now, I don't necessarily think they're going to be better than last year, so I'm not really necessarily buying in on that hype. Their over-under is currently 6, and I actually got them with the under. I got them winning only 4. Now, they got a pretty tough schedule to start the season. Now, UC Davis, that should be a win. But then you got Washington on the road, Ole Miss on the road. North Texas, you got them at home. That's not going to be, you know, an easy game for them, but I got them winning. Now, the rest of their schedule is tough. They got at Oregon, at Utah. They got to go to Stanford, got to go to UCLA, at home against Washington State and USC. It's going to be a tough year for Cal. I got them, as I mentioned, winning only 4. I could see them at the absolute most winning 6, breaking 500, going 6-6, but I think 4-6 wins is what we can anticipate for the Cal Bears. Moving on to one of the better teams now in the Pac-12, and that is Washington. Last season, Washington finished right at number 2, going 9-4, and their over-under this year is at 9.5. Now for that, I'm going to go with the over. I think Washington wins 11 games this year. Now, just like Oregon, Washington has a very, very easy schedule. They start the season Eastern Washington, Cal, Hawaii, and at BYU. I think that's a very, very easy 4-game schedule to begin the season. Then they got USC at home. I mean, really, their toughest road game this year is at Stanford. I mean, their only road games are at Colorado, at Oregon State, at Arizona, at Stanford, and at BYU. So I think those are all really winnable games, you know, on the road. And at home, they do have Oregon and Utah. I think they're going to lose at least one of those. Right now, I have them losing to Oregon, but I wouldn't be shocked if they lose to Utah as well. And I wouldn't be shocked if somehow, some way, Washington, they know they stumble at one of these road games. I don't think it's going to happen, but if they lose on the road to Stanford or Arizona, I wouldn't be too shocked. And of course, that game at the end of the year, the Apple Cup against Washington State, that's always a tough one as well. So I think Washington, I think that at the absolute worst, they finish 9-3, but I could see them easily finishing 11-1. Hey, maybe even going undefeated if they can beat Oregon. So I think Washington definitely has the chance to go undefeated, but right now I got them going 11-1. Moving now to the final team in the Pac-12 is Washington State, who finished last season number 1 atop the conference. They went 11-2, best record in the conference, and their current over-under is 8.5. And I got them just under with 8 wins. I got them losing at Arizona State, at Oregon. I got them winning only 8 games, so I'm going to go with the under. I think they're going to start the season strong. I think they're actually going to go on the road and beat Utah. That's kind of one of my hot takes right there. So that could be a loss based off that. But I think Washington State, I think they're going to be one of the better teams in the conference. But ultimately, I think they go 8-4. I think their ceiling is going 9-3. But I wouldn't be shocked also if they can stumble and end up at, I don't know, 6-6 or something like that. They definitely got some tough games playing Oregon, Washington, Arizona State, Utah, Houston. That's going to be a tough one. So Washington State, that's going to be an interesting thing to see how they do. But I got them going 8-4. But yeah, so those are my over-unders for the Pac-12. You know, my opinion, you know, I have some bold takes, so you guys can leave your thoughts below on what you think the over-unders are going to be for some of the Pac-12 teams. Let me know who you think a sleeper is that could potentially win the conference, who you think might be a team that could really stumble, be one of those teams that's completely a dumpster fire in 2019. So a lot can happen, so hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm going to be doing more of these in the coming weeks. I'm going to be doing them for all the Power 5 conferences, giving you my thoughts on the over-unders for those as well. So if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn notifications so you never miss a video. Make sure to follow me on Twitter where I'll be posting a bunch of updates with the show moving forward and just videos, all that fun stuff. So make sure to follow me on Twitter if you haven't already. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll see you guys very soon.